6:31 PM. Approval of minutes. We have 4 sets. One set really came in quite late this afternoon, so, but I'm wondering if we can at least say that we've reviewed the February 12th regular meeting and the 2 public hearing notes, and are good with filing them?
Yep.
The 12th, yes.
Yeah, February 12th, and as a regular meeting and the 2 public hearings. All right, so by consensus, Sally, we're going with those 3, and we're going to table the 20th. And we'll take a look at those next week. Any community input to start the meeting? Yes, Charlie?
I got a question on 112 Rollins Road. What's the status on that? I asked this question about 6 months ago, and you said it was in Tom Clark's and legal.
All right, we'll take a look at that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Can you make a note of that and see maybe we can figure that out? Thank you. All right, anything else?
No.
Another quick question. Okay, when Charlie Putman comes here, can we clarify what can be at the meet and greet and what can be handed out at the election? Can you hand things out at the election outside?
I don't know if
moderator... At the voting.
I don't think moderator has anything to say.
Okay, that's all. Thank you.
You mean the town hall?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, on the town hall voting.
And then the meeting.
And the
nothing
meeting.
Within, I know there's nothing within the building. There's no.
Now, I know that.
But
sometimes things get passed out outside. I'm just wondering what can be and what can't.
Yeah, 20 feet away.
There's a minimum feet. I don't remember what it is, but they can pass things as long as they're not within that buffer. I think that problem. Well, Charlie's a moderator. He can speak it, but the problem we ran into in the past, I think the buffer zone is larger than the.
Than what you have to stand?
The actual space that folks can stay in the middle of the street.
That's what it is. Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
I think it's sort of up to the, I would then assume that it's up to the discretion of the moderator.
That's why I'm. Thank you.
All right, department head, George.
I have to tell you, George, before you get started, I was going to send an email, but I got distracted that day. The last time we had snow.
Sunday?
Okay, the time before that, then. You're right, you could have some snow and it rained, but I had to go over to Dover and Summersworth for runs of errands, and our roads were far superior to anything like that. And they have full huge department. You have, you know, a much smaller bare bones crew. Okay, fair enough. But compared to the army that the city of Dover has, compared to what George has for resources, it was night and day, honestly. And in fact, when I came home, it was about noonish, maybe 1 o'clock. You were out doing the sidewalks on Main Street, I think is where you were at the time. But literally night and day. Mm-hmm. You go down the side streets in Dover, and it looked like nothing had been done.
Mm-hmm.
And then every side street that I went down in Rollins, or then I sort of said, "Oh, what is it like?" I drove around; it was immaculate. So, kudos to you and your crew.
Good feedback. Thank you.
I have PO for coal patch. We already did it, but the price coming after, and I'm not sure the price this year was 125 a ton. I didn't get 2 ton, so way more than 9 tons. So.
Purchase order number 1109 of Pike Industries for 2 tons of coal patch. Do we have a ballpark estimate?
It's going to be around $250.
So we need to put
it in the amount. We're going to put it in the amount, so why don't we just say up to $300?
Just put the amount, that's kind of what that means.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been running about 125
a ton, so gold. So I have a PO for $300 to Pike.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 So on Oak Street, we've got a few new openings, I think. Small things, yeah.
I saw that today. I got a little bit of shopping. Probably got away and I won't touch that one.
And the huge craters that you filled in are still filled, so
well, yeah,
for the most part.
We couldn't be done with hot top.
Yeah, but.
I worked out the mountain. deal with this now. We talked about stop signs, adding money into the budget for stop signs. I found a much more inexpensive way to replace them by just refacing them. And I got a PO for to reface. Well, it's cheaper by buying 25 faces at $583 instead of spending $2,000 on replacing all the stop signs. And we can wait till the budget's passed, or it's nothing that has to be done today.
It's probably better to be done in the spring, maybe, with weather or adherence?
It doesn't matter when we do. I mean, we got something that's got to be replaced.
I would say let's hang on to it, just for goodness sake.
And there's a few dead-end street signs.
But you can keep it in our folder. We can review it right after.
You can hold on to it.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, we'll just keep it here.
But, so...
If we have any questions, now's the time to ask.
Right, so are all the... You've been very checked on our doors, but I know probably the inventory is in probably various shape, you know, condition. So some of them may be in better shape than others. I know some of them may have been hit, knocked down, and put back up. So can you reface those? Or?
Most of them can be refaced.
Okay.
I only get 25. There's 30 some odd signs out there.
Right.
We have some signs that are on horses that we could reface and use.
Okay.
You know, backup signs.
Good. Do they send you the things, or do you have to send them out to be refaced?
No way.
You do it right on the job?
You can actually do it right
on the street. Oh, wow, okay, great.
We're going
to
try a few.
That's true.
We're going to try a few, you know.
Yeah.
Quality control.
Yeah, right.
See how it goes.
That's good.
You know, we have to take them down, clean them up, you know.
Yeah. That's great.
They said that they did good for about 10 years.
Really? I don't think they last that long anyway. They usually get stolen or knocked down.
They were knocking out.
Yeah, that's great.
That's great. So it shouldn't be public.
What's that?
A quote from Pike.
Oh, yeah.
No, that's not what I'm talking about. Did you want part of the PO?
Oh.
I get both parts.
Do we have the name?
Oh, for the coal patch.
I'm sorry, yes. For the coal patch, yes, we should put it, keep it together. That's what you're talking about.
We have to get the bill on this.
Is that okay?
That's...
Did we get the overhead taken care of and the highways there?
The lot is up, yeah.
It is, okay.
We're just finishing up some things, putting a little bit of extra power up there so we can have all this.
Yeah. And are you still thinking about trying to...
Grinding.
We were probably going to wait till after that meeting anyway, so...
We'll work to that.
Awesome.
Good project.
Not over yet, is it?
We'd like to think
it's
it is.
I wish.
All right, I think we're good.
Okay.
Thank you. Is this says Goodyear tire?
I'm sorry?
No.
What is this? Sullivan Tire Company?
It just needs a signature to keep our account with those two tire providers active. It certifies that we're buying them for governmental purposes so that we get government pricing.
Oh, that we're a state or local government? Oh, okay. So do we have to sign this?
Yeah. Both of them. No,
George,
no.
Right? Okay. So I will sign this. Very good.
It's good here, what's the other one?
You might know what that is.
Yeah, hang on. I'll tell you. This one is...
There's probably two different sources in the area, Bridgestone and Goodyear. Goodyear, so we get discounts.
Brown's retirement, okay. Bridgestone?
And Goodyear. Police usually go through more tires than the highway department in the airport. Most typically.
The Anderson, I hereby certify I'm the chair of the select board of the town of Brownsburg and is the ultimate purchaser. Okay, so I am the purchaser. Purchaser name.
It's just we get a government rate of that government. Just that you're attesting that you're not buying them for the village, you're buying it for the town.
Exactly.
Help you go past.
Certified.
Right.
Okay, they're signed. Okay. Are we good? George, we're good with you. Okay, so, Mr. Moderator, I think we're ready for you.
You're not taking me out of order?
No.
All right. Is
nobody here? You're here, and we're ready to rock and roll.
All right.
So, before we go to the warrant, there was a question from Charlie Dion during community input, wondering about handing out materials, what sort of campaign materials in front of town hall, and what are there... geographic restrictions and what are they?
On election day?
Yes.
I think that there are, but let me check.
Okay.
I
know people have done it in the past.
Yeah, from the steps forward.
There are, Charlie, but they're so large, you'd be in the middle of Main Street, I think.
Okay.
I mean,
and traditionally we've done...
It's been at the moderator's discretion, I think.
Let me take a look.
They're not passing them out in the building, I think, is what the previous moderator was.
Yeah, there was like two parking spaces that were there when we stood out there.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Just so you weren't like harassing people going in the door. Yeah.
You know that people have conventionally stood right up to the steps.
Right.
That may or may not be correct.
Right. I think that's up to Charlie.
Look, of course, in this day and age where the Secretary of State is threatening to throw us all into jail, don't know what to do anymore. But okay, I'll check on that. And I see Mr. Dion right here tonight. Do you want me to be in touch with him or be back in touch with you and you'll convey it?
You can answer. Well, I copy it. We would need to know in case we get another question. Okay, you can answer.
Okay, yeah, because... My sense is we want to try to have it be fair for...
Yeah, and the other thing was at the meet and greet, can you hand out things there at the library?
Oh, yeah. That's the library's function. Yeah, I mean, that's their function, and I don't think... Yeah, that's
fine. Okay.
So, Charlie, do you have an email address?
No, he doesn't.
Your better half has one, okay.
You're right, my better half.
I'm trying to bring up an electronic version of our warrant. Here it is.
My first
for
question
you.
Is going to be, do we have a warrant?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
That there, the official copy is the one that says February 20th, right at the end. We're hoping that's the version that gets into the printed copy of the warrant. We did sign one on the 12th, and then we've heard from the DRA belatedly about having to rework two of our warrant articles. They're not really not material, but we still have one of those.
For the election ballot?
No.
No, for the town meeting?
For the town meeting.
There were ones that we've had on the warrant.
The one we've had on the warrant forever. So,
land use transfer stack.
Yes, I'll get it in a minute. I'm still trying to get it. Hang on.
That's fine.
I would be just guessing if they said that a lawyer had been involved in finding something they were forced to do.
I don't think so.
No,
I don't know why she noticed it this time and not last year or the year before.
20 years ago.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so articles 1 through 3 are going to be on the ballot and not at the Saturday town meeting. And otherwise, starting with Article 4, we have the articles for town meeting. So I don't know if you just want to go through them one at a time, or... There is nothing that requires a, other than a majority vote, or there is nothing that requires, a paper ballot. And if you get to Article 11, so in that one, we had to strike the last sentence, which you don't see. The last sentence said, in the event the land use change tax fund contains less than $10,000, the remainder will come from unassigned fund balance with no amount to be raised by taxation. No, it doesn't belong there. So we said, fine, there is money in the land use change tax, so. Right, so it's kind of a moot issue, but so that was the change we made to that. Hopefully that is the one that will be printed in the annual report. And the other change we had to make was to Article 14, the petition warrant article, even though the purpose, the heading for it said by petition, as you can see, she wanted us to include the word by petition within the text. So we did. That was the only other change.
Just so I can begin to understand how the debate is likely to go, does the operating budget contain, let's see, the operating budget as warranted, does it contain the sum of
$250,000? No, it does not. The budget committee chose not to put it back. So it does not. So it's not recommended by us.
Okay.
And so the warrant, so there will be guidance at that meeting from us to reinstate that $250,000, as well as within a later on to, assuming that that passes, that we would then guide the legislative body to reduce the other one to $1.
So in presenting the budget, the select board is likely to ask for an amendment in the amount of $250,000 for road repairs.
Yes.
That's okay.
Yes. All of the other appropriated articles, with the exception of the one that's in there by petition from road resurface, is recommended by both the board and the budget committee.
Article 13, is that non-controversial or?
Well, we're housing standards. I don't know. We don't know. We had a public hearing. There were two or three people who attended. Two of them were concerned that we were perhaps too restrictive, coming down with a heavy hand. And this, unashamedly, we took this right from Dover. As you know, we normally find somebody to copy, hooks, line, and sinker from. So there were, and apparently none of us had read it on first reading, though that otherwise it would have come out of there right away. There was something about morals. So
we saw it and didn't.
We saw it and it didn't register. So anyway, we did remove that. So we've made some changes, and we did have one of the Lorraine Hansen was one of the people who was here that night, making some comments, and she kind of worked with Tom, our building inspector. Tom agreed with some of the recommendations. Some of them were things like changing the language to be more generalized. So in other words, instead of saying as tying it to just a more general standard rather than something specific, so that we wouldn't have to keep changing this and changing this. So that was the part of it. So we're not anticipating any particular controversy. That one's, we didn't have people really show up en masse at the public hearing. And I haven't heard, has anybody heard anything?
Nope.
So, we hear more about people complaining about troubled properties in town than we would a about people complaining about raising the standards, I think, so. And this would take care of several properties in town. We don't have tools at our disposal now. I mean, there are certain sanitary codes that we can, RSAs that we can point to, but besides that, we don't have the means.
And this gives us the power to fine. So.
And the action of the legislative body will be to adopt this ordinance or not, or is the body making a recommendation to the board? And the board will.
No, it's to adopt.
To adopt, yeah. They have the power for this particular kind of ordinance, we don't. So it has to be approved by the legislative body.
And so by a warrant article, the select board is proposing a series of ordinances. And unlike some ordinances that the governing body has authority to adopt, this is one where the legislative body must adopt.
Correct.
We're very limited in what.
Yeah.
Roads also.
Roads we can. We can do ordinances associated with public safety.
Sorry, I was gonna say certain public.
Certain public safety, yeah. Argue that this might be public safety, but.
But not this.
No, we checked with the municipal association and they said, you know, we really need to bring this to the voters, so. So, okay. You know, changing the road name, this is, we're undoing what we did last year. For one of them, because it was never put in practice. It was too difficult to put in practice. It had to do something about Summersworth and.
It was more confusing than.
So Chief Ducharme said, it's just not gonna work. So I said, okay, then just to dot the I and cross the T, we'll bring it back to the voters. Just to make it.
E911 folks thought it was clarifying and it caused more confusion than anything else, so.
Yeah, it looks like it could be a busy town meeting, so adopting the town manager, it's a committee to explore adopting the town manager form. Imagine that makes some explanation. Imagine the historical committee expense of trust or change in road name is likely to.
Okay.
So we'd like.
You never know.
Yep.
I did print out as well I only have two copies, you can look at this, but this is, you know, the 10% rule, et cetera, for budget changes.
Yes.
So I doubt that we're going to have to address this, but the maximal allowable appropriation is 2.755 million, so. And I don't see where anybody's going to be making amendments to add that amount of money to anything, so. It's the bottom line. So the other, so the road warrant is just a swap. It doesn't come into play.
Okay. So the warranted articles bring us up to 2,432. And
who knows? Those are, well, minus the, yes, the long-term bond notes, yes. Yes.
All right. And I think last year, Suzanne, you helped me do the math. Like,
yes. This is done for us, so I thought I'd give it to you.
Okay.
That's the math. As long as no one amends something to take us beyond 2.755, yes, we'll do the addition.
Okay.
I
live in.
Fear,
yes,
yeah, no worries. I do the same here at night, because after like 7 o'clock, I can't add 2 plus 2. And great the rest of the time, it's a little differential calculus, but.
Yeah, and for me, you add some, you know, kind of the social stress of being in front of a group
exactly.
of people.
Exactly, I understand completely.
And some moving parts with, you know, this happening and this happening and this
yes,
other thing
we'll
happening.
Yes, we'll be right there.
And then
right behind you, I think is what it is, right? We'll be right behind
we'll talk
you.
Layout here in just a second, okay. I would just, I mean, if it happens, I'll take responsibility for it, but I'd hate to be responsible for it.
DRA did it for us.
Yes. Yes, but.
After Suzanne put all the work in putting it into the system. But.
If somebody starts saying, I want to add this, I want to add this, I want to add this,
right.
We need to know what point it's too much.
Right.
Again, the likelihood of that happening is small, but, you know,
I think
be prepared.
To be prepared.
Be prepared. So, also, Charlie, we haven't done this yet, but we'll, you know, the three of us will talk about. You know, introducing one of the warrants.
Yes,
so we'll give that to you, so you can.
Okay.
We we just don't know what it is right now. Who wants to speak to what?
In all the petitioned ones, there would be responsibility of the petitioners, right? Introduce, not us.
I don't know that they need introduction, or just they just sit there.
The moderator introduced them, but they want to speak to them. We would get up and speak to all the other ones.
Right, exactly. We are not going to speak to by petition, of which there are two in the Saturday.
Yeah.
Oh, no, we will speak to the historical one, I think, because we're recommending it.
That's by petition, though.
By petition.
I'll generally recognize the petitioner first.
Fine, David, it's fine.
And my practice has been that, particularly if the select board wants to make an official statement about this is the position of the select board on this warrant article, I'll recognize a member of the board will do that.
Well, no, actually, we did not recommend the roads resurfaces. We did recommend the historical committee. And we are completely neutral on the
other two.
Town manager, the other two.
Oh, the other one's on the.
The other one's on the ballot.
Town manager is petition.
Yeah.
So it's town manager, and do you know who the petitioners, who I should contact?
It's on the website.
Okay.
It's on the website. All the petition warrants are there with the petitioners.
Okay. So it's the historical committee, expendable trust, the town manager study committee, it's the $250,000 road improvement fund.
Correct.
Is that 14? And then SB2 is on election day.
Correct. Yeah, we have the other town officers, which is always a fun time.
Yep. And last year, I had requested that we try to have a slate when I open nominations for fence viewer.
Maybe one of us can work on that?
We can probably do it by then, just to see if there are people that we need to honor or anyway. It's not like, or if there are folks that are no longer with us, we want to look at that right now. Before, we don't embarrass ourselves and say we have done that in the past.
Yeah, well, I think, did Paul Janitis pass on?
No.
No, he's still.
Okay. Not George, okay.
And the other one, right?
I don't know.
Okay. Okay. Then, not sure why I had the impression that one of the people that I thought was perennial name, but that's fine. I'm sort of torn on that. I think that people enjoy it a little bit. On the other hand, they enjoy the part of the town meeting thing. On the other hand, being able to move through it efficiently, I think, is helpful. Mm-hmm. I'm afraid this is going to be another long day.
I think Parks and Recs are the only. Two positions. There's usually three, isn't it?
Yes.
That we have no open circle, right?
Concern about that.
And try to find people, but make sure those two people still want to do it, right?
Yes. To get back to your comment about, I'm thinking it's going to be shorter than last year. We had to keep the polls open for an hour on three different occasions. We had a number of times when we received the ballots.
Maybe again.
Yeah, you never know, right? You never know. But, a lot of these things are, many of them are pretty cut and dry. So we'll see.
We'll see.
Just never know.
I will try to help promote a fair and open discussion.
Friendly, absolutely.
As much as I can.
And you do a good job, Charlie, so we appreciate it.
Do you have any requests on changes to layout? It's kind of a standard.
Yeah, no, select board up front,
budget committee
on the side.
To the right, podium and microphone for Franklin.
Right. The question about swearing in. So this was kind of a sort of a new understanding last year, I think, that in order to preside over the meeting, that the swearing in should happen at the end of the meeting. So in other words, unless there's another way to do it, but so Jody, for example, is not running. It would still be there through the meeting as the board member who brought all of this together this year.
Yep.
So, and I guess, and so did we do the swearing in at the end?
We did, I think at Kate's request.
Okay, all right.
I think it was, again, it's one of those ceremonial parts of the meeting that people sort of enjoyed, and I think some people had left because it was such a long meeting. But it strikes me that there's a governance and operational reason to put it to the end, partly for the visual for voters at the town meeting to understand that this is the board that is responsible at the March 2018 town meeting. The new board is going to be responsible at the March 2019 meeting. So I like it from that standpoint. In terms of answering questions that come up, there may be things, particularly that Jody will be the person, and to put the new person on the spot to, even entertain the question of whether or not she's going to answer it doesn't seem fair. So,
should we put the select board elect at the table so they get the feeling? Or
no?
No.
We are the elected body, so we are presiding over.
And you've been until the town meeting, right? Yeah.
You'll have to suffer the slings and arrows for
one more meeting.
The first meeting was the easiest. Mike's like, she's been here an hour. So.
Well, see, that's why we did it differently that
exactly.
time.
Right.
And that's, we've changed that so that.
Mm-hmm.
My sense is that what you do as the governing body is difficult enough, complex enough, sensitive enough, that having the people in place who've had to go through the decision-making process, it's only fair to the voters that they get to see and talk to the people who've been doing the work. So I'm comfortable postponing it. I think my understanding was that legally we could have it where it was and just say that it didn't take effect until the end of our meeting.
Mm-hmm.
But
okay, and I know that Kate is around to administer the oath during the week for those who aren't there, couldn't stay, whatever, so I think we're good.
Yeah. I'm happy to do it.
Okay.
And I thought I would, at the school district meeting, I asked school children to lead the pledge. I'd probably ask a vet, maybe Joe, if he's there.
That's a wonderful sound, yeah.
Very nice.
So if you have thoughts on that, somebody you'd like to see do it, or...
I'm fine with it. That's good.
Use of technology, plan to use the PowerPoint again?
Yes. It's up on the stage now, which I think what we might ask the school to do is to bring the chairs closer. I mean, there's such a gap between the first row,
right.
and so if we could bring the chairs forward, then at least people in the first row can see it. Better.
Yeah.
So yes, it will, the warrants will be posted.
And this is where it gets dicey with petition articles. Generally the advice of the Municipal Association, the training that they gave us, and the advice in the book is if it's available for the select board to use, the governing body to use, then I should make it available to petitioners. One way to make that happen is to have petitioners who want to use PowerPoint send you a PowerPoint slide deck.
Right.
Another, I know a lot of petitioners like to, start yanking cables.
I don't think we're doing any presentations. I mean, this is just the warrant. We're just displaying the warrant.
Okay. I don't have a problem with if people want to post something. I mean, during their part of the presentation. I can't imagine what they want to do, but. We're not presenting anything. I get what you're saying, but
I don't believe so.
Did we
do it in the past?
We did it during the public hearing, but not during the
The public hearing.
But not during the town meeting. I don't think we did.
But sir, it will be up to you.
To you. Okay.
It'll be entirely up to you.
Last year, I gave some kind of moderator's introduction, and I had moderator's rules. Any questions, concerns, comments, requests for changes, shorten it, longen it.
Don't longen it.
Don't longen
it. Do anything you can to shorten it.
Yeah.
I'll do my best. I mean, I'm no longer a new moderator, and so there may be less need for me to explain what I might be doing and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Having printed copies is just fine, too. I'd be just explaining to people that it's a civil conversation. We're all neighbors, you know. They'll live near one another. We should be nice to each other. We don't have to agree, but disagree with everything, disagreeable, that's what I'm doing.
See what I can do.
No name calling, no profanity, sort of thing.
Election day. I'll talk to Kate about it. Do you have any questions or concerns about election day?
No, we might have another of the four, you know, the stand-up stations where four people can.
Okay.
We, it was in the budget, so I don't know when she. I think we had a purchase order, so that could change a little bit. I don't know. So it could look a little different on the side. I don't really know if she's going to set it up, but I don't have any other particular comments. It was just a question about, you know, electioneering out there outside.
I spoke with Kate. I believe that she's going to retain custody of the voter checklist until the morning. And I think there's going to be a request for the supervisors to be there early.
We're back to talking to town meeting?
I'm sorry, we're back to town meeting.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm apologizing.
I
changed course on you. Yes, for morning of town meeting, I think. I was concerned. I think we were 15 minutes late getting started.
Yes, we were all concerned. Yes.
And I don't think that's...
It's not fair to...
It's not fair to anybody. I don't know. I will reread the statutes.
Well, we have three supervisors with the checklist, and there are just two at the deliberative session.
I think there were just two.
Is there a way to deputize a third? Because, I mean, clearly, the more, if you've got three input stations, then you can process them more quickly.
I'll see. May not have that authority as moderator. You may have that as the government worked out.
Just let us know if that's so, then we can try to effectuate that.
Yeah. Election day. Is it a voting machine day?
Yes, and Kate is going to be testing on
the sixth.
That's all she told us. She didn't give a time. But normally we put it out on the website and it's public,
yes.
So people can come in while the testing is going on, and also she looks for volunteers. So that will be sometime during the day, I suspect, on...
Oh, you need to do that, Dr. Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
It's at night, I think. So
I'm sorry?
She's planning on 6.
6 o'clock. Oh, okay, sorry, not during the day, 6 o'clock. Here.
I will work with her tomorrow about a proper posting.
Yeah, because it should be posted so people know, and us also. She didn't ask. I assume that she's getting volunteers. She wasn't asking us to find volunteers, so I think she was just notifying us.
Charlie, I just sent you her email that she sent to us. I don't know if she sent it to you.
I don't think so. The statute, I'm not sure that she has to have the moderator there, but maybe that's what the statute says. So whatever the statute says.
All I remember is that it has to be, we have to notice, you have to post it so that people can come and see. You know, because you want everybody to feel comfortable with the, you know, legitimacy and accuracy, whatever, of the voting machine. And so it's an elaborate process that, you know, that she goes through based on the recommended processes of the folks that you bought it from.
Right. It makes good sense to test the machine out. And given the, you know, what we're seeing in the press about the challenges to the integrity of the voting process,
right.
You know, from all sides of the political spectrum, it's not a left or right issue. It's not, you know, so.
Our machine's been pretty darn good, though.
The paper ballot is holding up a lot better than the electronic systems.
Right. It's a vote counting machine, not an electronic voting machine. That's the difference.
And there are lots of good ways to double and triple check, which is all good. Easy ways to manage recounts. But testing it is part of the process, and it's all good. suggestions or concerns, anything you've heard from voters that they don't do or don't like about the way the meeting is run?
All right.
It's always interesting.
So if not before, we'll see you on election day.
Yes. And I don't know that I have any update for you on SB 438. The Senate was going to take that. That was the...
The cancellation and postponement issue.
The Senate was going to take it up on Thursday and postponed it, which...
There were a number of bills.
Was it a snow day?
No.
They postponed it. Thank you. Thank you, Charlie.
I got it.
Thank you.
I got it. Yes. So it wasn't, I was hoping that it was something special, but no, okay.
There were a number, I had to go to work, but I was tracking them. It just... If a senator had another meeting and they couldn't be on the floor, and Senator Bradley was in out a lot, meeting at the governor's office for, on Medicaid, so. The boss isn't there, it's hard to have a, hard to bring a bill to the floor, so.
And that bill had a lot of co-sponsors, so I guess.
Yeah.
I was hoping. But the more that we see in terms of the analysis of that bill, the worse it is. There are some bills that you can look at and say, oh, you know, conservatives would like this, or liberals would like this. This is a thing you look at and you go, this is
a bipartisan mess.
This is like...
Well, you look at the sponsors. I mean, it's truly, they're both sides. It's not, like, dominated by one party or the other. It's equal numbers.
Yeah, it seems to be people who hate local government. And what? Okay. Get involved and change local government.
Yeah, exactly. In legal ways.
Yeah. You know, let's make sure that local government cannot function, is what that bill looks like. Anyway, okay.
Thank you so much, Charlie.
Thank you also. I appreciate it. Thank you. Take care. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
Thanks, Kim. I think we did go for it. I think that's why we see. So we're going to do fire first?
Got people expecting it. Yeah, you've got a good one.
Folks waiting on you?
Just kind of finding his radar. Well, first piece of business is a one PO that I have for this evening. It's 1636. It's for the State Department of Safety. It's for a training class that four of our members took. Is for to become a certified fire inspector. Kevin's our main inspector, and Kevin's ability to do a lot of stuff is dwindling because he's got some health issues, so he has been down. So had four individuals that stepped up and want to take the class, and they want to go to the fire department to do initial investigations on the fire scene. We used our own folks on the fire. We had an Oak Street a month or so ago, and typically, that's how we handle most things within our scope. Of course, if there's anything above that, if there's a fatal, the state has to come in. If there's a certain dollar amount lost, the state has to be called in. That's just state statute that we have to do that. And these four individuals went, took the class, and become certified, so now we have a lot more flexibility within the department to have our fires taken care of. So that's, like I said, 1336 to the state for 11.
Move to accept.
All passed. That's the big thing. Sometimes I send them to class and they don't do it. They all pass.
Move to accept purchase order 1336 to the State of New Hampshire Department of Safety for inspection class certification for four staff members. Okay.
Yeah.
I see three.
Yeah, I wrote three on there with this.
Okay. So for a total of $1,170.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Does it say three?
Yeah. I just didn't put the fourth there.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Title for engine 2, so the community now has that. I gave it to Carol tonight so it can get forward. that's official and that paperwork is all done. Now for the final rights to ending the bridge.
And the date is?
I got two sets of dates for you to use, whichever fits for them. The 6th or the 7th of March.
6th.
Or the 15th and 16th.
It's going to take 2 days, is that why you're giving me 2 sets?
It's going to take 2 days. What's going to happen is the truck has to be delivered to the salvage yard on day 1, because they have to drain all the fluids out of the truck.
It's like embalming.
Exactly right. Everything has to come out of the truck, so they need a day to make sure that is all done. The 2nd day would be the day that the actual destruction occurs. So if that's...
Okay, so 6th and 7th in March, what? Then the 2nd set?
15th and 16th.
Okay, I will get in touch with Liz tomorrow.
Yep.
And see what she has to say. And it is, again, Berwick Salvage, is that the name?
Yep. Number 236.
Berwick Salvage.
Berwick Iron and Salvage is what it's called.
Iron and Salvage. 236. Okay.
So if they need to come, it would be the 2nd of the 2 days. If they can't, or they don't choose to, it can be videotaped by the salvage yard. They will tape the actual demise of the truck. Photos and or a video can be provided. Truck will be brought there, will be weighed. There will also be a check to the town. Whatever the weight is.
Oh, I see. It's salvage material.
Correct. Mm-hmm. And yeah. I don't have any clue on what that would be, because, you know, you get so much for aluminum, so much for steel, and so whatever they give us.
They may also want some stills of the, just as per the terms and conditions.
We'll have anything that they want.
Okay.
I'm going to have members are going to be there. I'll probably be there. A couple of guys want to come and get the last rites, so they want to be there. Mm-hmm. So between people just taking stuff on their own, you know, camera phones and stuff, and videos, there'll be plenty of documentation as to what's going on to meet the stipulations within our grant and whatnot.
Okay.
Okay, so.
All right, I'll keep you posted. I'll copy you on the emails to Liz at DES, and we'll see what
she's still, I mean, because before it was still up in the air whether they were going to attend.
She just, I don't know. She said, let us keep us posted.
Yep.
So when I told her that it was going to happen soon, she says, okay, let me know. So I don't know.
Yep, because I know the clock started ticking, two's officially in service now. So that's why we kind of making sure we fall within that 15-day time frame. So.
And the official date of service is, was today?
Will be March 1st.
It's going to service March
1st. March 1st, the official date that we will call in service. We've used it a couple of times. But we're still finishing up with the equipment, so what, March 1st is Thursday? That will be the official date that it's 100% in service.
All right.
The other thing with it is, as we've taken everything off, because some guys wanted stuff for souvenirs and whatnot, but I also contacted a guy that had done some work for us before from Red Light Industries. He lives up in York, and he has his own. What it is, it's he installs lighting on emergency vehicles. He had done some of us in the past on the utility. Well, I contacted him to come down because there's still an awful lot of very good equipment on engine 3. He has come down, I met with him there last week, and he's going to take us about every light off of engine 3 to the tune of about $8,000 that we are taking from the upgrade when engine 3 was upgraded 10 years ago. All that stuff was LED, high-end lighting. All that's coming off of 3 and it's going to be put on engine 1. So basically, engine 1 is getting an upgrade out of this whole thing also, to the tune of about $8,000. That'll be LED from brake lights to directionals to a whole new light bar to
the
lighting system.
When you say $8,000, you don't mean like an additional cost.
Oh, no, I'm saying
$8,000. The value.
Value
coming from one to the other. No, there's no cost to the value.
Are clear on that.
Yeah, his fee for, he was removing some of the stuff, but he got a little bit tied up, so our guys have been doing that. But he's going to be the one that's going to install all the stuff onto. So it's getting an update. So in that regard, engine 3 is going to live on through engine 1, through its lighting.
Oh, that's nice.
For its, till the end of its service life, too. So. But it's going to be a well-needed upgrade for it, because it doesn't have the same capacity with when it's kind of when it's emergency lighting now. Well.
Okay.
So that's something we managed to salvage off this whole thing, too. I don't want to make you aware of.
All right. Thank you. thinking.
That's where we are. We're all set. Yeah, you just tell me what you find out and what
and
we
the
need
board,
to do.
In case the board also wants to attend.
Yeah, we plan to bring it over first thing. Like I said, the first day is when we're driving over there, leaving pretty much. The second day
is the day.
7 or 16 would be the day when the actual.
When's the next breakfast?
We've lost them again. Or?
We yeah, we are. We've lost two.
Okay.
We're not. It should be this Saturday, but we're not.
Not there. Okay.
On this Saturday.
All right.
The station is in such a disarray.
That's fine. I just.
And if you went up there right now and saw the way engine 3 is with all the parts and pieces everywhere,
fair enough.
Just trying to move things out and set up was not very conducive. So once the truck's gone, things settle back down, we're going to be back up and running in April.
Good.
April and May we'll do it. And okay. We're going to have a kind of conjunction of the fact that, like an open house if not, so
oh, nice.
The engine will be
yeah.
sitting there so people can go over and check it out.
That's great.
And the April and whatnot, so some of that stuff has been made available to us to be visible for everybody to come and take a look at.
Okay.
All right. Very good.
Okay.
All right, we're good. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You too. Are we doing
off
now?
We are.
We're going to go on to non-public
not
session
yet.
For the focus of the hearing welfare petition.
Second. Roll call. Mike?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Zena? Yes. All right, so Sally, we just exited the usual way. Okay.
Yeah, please.
And let us know when you're ready to have a start.
I did it wrong on those minutes.
Which ones? The 20th? I'll take a look at that.
Yeah.
I'll take
that's a all I did was cut and paste to that, but I just now realized that.
We can talk afterwards or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
So for welfare, I'll just do both together. Welfare case 2018-002, the select board's recommending. Up to $750 in rental assistance. And in case 2015-014, up to $400 in rental assistance.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 2015-040?
014.
014.
400.
Administration. So I believe our warrant is posted up there, as it had to be by today, the warrant and the budget. The annual town report is at the printers. It needs to be out by the 6th, so we're hoping that happens.
Thank you. Thank you, Jody, for
yes.
coming in the other night. So,
sorry.
Well, I guess I'm not that sorry because I saw that you waited around for someone for nothing, I guess. So.
I've kind of been doing other things.
Thank you for that.
Oh, well.
You met with our moderator, so we've done that. Nothing else? Any additional information on child care?
Mm-hmm. Still just two.
Okay.
No word of it.
Community table. So we have had a request from the Garden Club, the Rawlsburg Garden Local Sustainability Club, to have a table where they would like to sell ducks and also hand out flyers for the Stratford County Conservation District.
I was wondering what that was.
That's what that is. Yes. One of our board members is also a board member of the Stratford County
Conservation
District.
They have a plant sale right now.
Yes, and that's, I think,
that's
she,
flyer,
wants to,
oh, good.
That's, yeah, she wants to publicize mm-hmm. that. And you were, I think, is the REC committee also interested in having a table?
The REC committee wanted to have a bucket over here for donations like they did last year, and then a table at town meeting as well, I believe. So last year we got like $160-something.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, that's fine.
The historical committee would like to have a table too at town meeting, I think.
Okay. The only thing you have to sort of like be in charge of making sure that whatever table and equipment you want is there, right? It's not necessarily set up or even available.
We bring our own table.
The Garden Club has done that in the past or checked with somebody or whatever, but all I'm saying is we three are not.
We're giving permission to allow them
permission.
To have space. Yeah, that's
yes.
what I'm saying.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. They would want to be included too. Even if they decide they don't want to, but.
Yeah. Right, that's fine.
Like to have a table.
Yeah, I don't think there's a problem with any of these three groups. They're all community, clearly community groups, so I think we're good there. Management letters. So we got the management letter from Tom our auditor, Tom Dumay, and normally we have a response. We usually try to get in time for the annual meeting, but his management letter was late, and so that's just not going to happen. But what I thought would be helpful, you know, I'm happy to draft a response, but it would, you know, as long as it's not written yet, I'd like to get input from this group, if you have any. So, you know, the good news is there was no material deficiency found, so that's good, yay. But he had some, other recommendations to make. So, one was with regard to computer applications. He was saying that he got some material from us and it had a virus, so he's just recommending that we have our machinery scanned and have appropriate antivirus stuff. So I will just say that yes, we sort of support that and blah, blah, blah. Transfer station receipts. So he is recommending that we not manage cash at the transfer station. Okay. He is recommending that, you know, we could have a cash register perhaps. The tape at the end would support the receipts, but he's also saying that right now homeowners are allowed to pay by cash or check. This should be changed to only accept checks and not cash.
Does everyone have a check account?
I don't know.
Then everybody would have a checking account, right? One problem.
Or even remember to bring the checkbook with them. I mean,
right.
So didn't you say that one town had some interesting way to help manage that?
Yes.
Am I remembering that correctly?
Yes, they had, you had to put the money into the machine and it spit you out a ticket. So I still have it in my pictures if I can find it.
Could bring cash, but it wouldn't go directly to a person. It would be put into this machine.
Into the machine. And the machine is inside the building. One of the buildings.
Yeah.
That was way back when.
Remember
Lee does it.
Lee?
All right, well, if you could find it, just email that along.
Okay.
And we'll, you know, because we can say that we're looking at that. You know, because really what we want to do is we want to let the town know and let our auditor know that we're taking these things seriously. And, you know, we're looking into, you know, various and sundry things. So that's a transfer station. He said something really interesting about stickers. Presently, citizens of the town may go to the town clerk and purchase a transfer station sticker for $10, the second sticker an additional $5.
There it is.
Okay, I'll keep waiting. Yeah, just, can you just send that?
I'll send it on.
Send it to all three of us, not just to me, that would be super. The workers at the transfer station are required to verify all vehicles entering the transfer station have a proper sticker in their vehicle. This has created situations when town citizens who have not purchased a sticker are turned away. The transfer station attendants now become enforcement officers. To prevent the situation from escalating further, I don't know who we spoke with, it's interesting, the board should consider imposing a fine when transfer station stickers are purchased after December 31st. I don't know how this addresses what the enforcement business.
It definitely doesn't.
So this one confuses me, and I may just draft something that's vague and saying we'll continue to look at ways to manage that. But
yeah,
I don't know how you get out. If they're supposed to, they're the ones who say,
right,
check if you have it. It's like going to the movies and you bought your ticket at home. You have to show it to them. And that's, is that person an enforcement person? If you don't have a ticket, they're not going to let you in. Right? So I thought that was odd.
I would think to prevent the situation, what is it from?
Sorry, he's just saying escalating further, the town should consider imposing a fine.
Individuals should be fined for not having a sticker, is what I would say, not having bought it after the 31st. Someone could have, you know,
thank you,
been away for a few weeks and bought their sticker after the 31st. You're going to fine them because they bought it a week later?
That part doesn't make sense. But
people go away for the winter,
so,
and then they come back in the spring and they get fined because they bought a sticker in May instead of, yes, nuts.
So I'll draft something and you can see how you think about it.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Town administrator. Presently, the select board oversees the daily ops of the town. The board positions are part-time yet very demanding in dealing with town affairs. Town growth and current demands to major improvements of the town's infrastructure, as well as maintaining a balanced budget and accountability to the citizens of the town, is time-consuming. Consideration should be given to changing the responsibility of the board by adding a town administrator. It's recommended that the board give serious consideration to adding a new position as town administrator. Well, so obviously that's something that I know that we've talked about. I know that personally, I think the town needs, and there are several people who have talked about that. So that's an interesting thing to hear from our auditor.
I think that's really overstepped. Not that I disagree with him, I really think it's overstepping its boundaries.
In what way?
Telling the town how to run its town.
It's a recommendation.
I just...
Well, it has to do with accountability and enforcement, right? So if he's, you know, if the people who are...
It's not that I don't agree with that. I just, this is our auditor. This is the money guy.
Right, we make sure that we have appropriate controls and enough people to manage the controls, that we have the appropriate knowledge base to understand the rules and regulations associated with making sure that the town is running properly.
So what is recommended the board give serious consideration?
Yeah, he's not saying to hire a town administrator. He's just, you know, this is one of his recommendations based on what he sees, what he knows as far as state regs and that sort of thing.
I see.
Recreation Department. During the past year, all recreation revenues were deposited into the town's general fund. The town paid all summer employees and operating expenses. The system improved the accountability of the Recreation Department.
Yay! You actually know who works there and everything.
It is recommended that the town continue to control revenue expenses in the next fiscal year as it has during the current year. So it's nice to get the feedback that, you know, we actually took some advice and put it in place and this sort of thing. Purchase orders, same thing. It's the same stuff.
Before, not after.
Before, not after. Cemetery funds. Trustees maintain a spreadsheet. MSNI report agrees to the difference. All right, so it's just the reconciliation process that's been ongoing for years, which I think is now reconciled. I believe there's a note that the trustees of the trust funds inserted with their report that said that things are fine. Although he's saying the process needs to be monitored until the perpetual care accounts and the bank balance are in agreement. So I don't know if there's yet another issue, but anyway, we can check in with the trustees of the trust funds about that. Capital assets, he's saying here, we don't maintain records of general capital assets. I emailed them the spreadsheet. I mean, it's true, we don't have every blessed capital asset, but we certainly have gone a long way. I wish he had just said that.
All the major capital assets are on the spreadsheet. What is he suggesting is missing? Did he say, I can't see it, I'm
well,
sorry.
Well, he's not saying, he's just saying... Recording of capital assets would fulfill the need to provide for physical dollar value control. I mean, he's not saying that, he's not identifying particular pieces. If you recall last year, I said, look, guide us, you know, give us some idea of what we can do to make
this
come up to your muster. We didn't hear anything back, so it's the same thing. I'll probably say the same thing. Petty cash. Presently, the tax collector and town clerk maintain a petty cash box. The collection of funds needs to be secured and not left in a cash box in public view. One option could be the use of a cash register with a password required to gain access. And the cash register would also have the ability to summarize funds collected at the end of the day.
Where is there a cash box that's in public view?
Well, there's one there. I mean, they both have cash boxes, the front office and Caroline. Well, they are if you
pull them out.
I don't
know.
I mean, it's not like they're hanging out on the counter,
right.
But they're on behind a locked door with cameras on them.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
So. I'm confused, but okay.
Needs to be secured and not left in a cash box in public. Are you suggesting
so we can buy a $99 register
like
with tape?
Cheapo one, right? Exactly.
Yeah,
I have no. Is that what they cost?
Yeah, you
no
don't
idea.
Have to buy like a.
I have no clue.
A huge high end that you can, you know, purchase, you know, put POS point of sale info.
Yeah.
And what do we need that for?
We're not selling anything.
No.
It's also possible. possible that it may help them cash out at the end of the day.
Quite possible, yeah.
I don't really know, I don't...
It just takes up counter space, so you would need to figure out where you would put it, but that's not really that big of an issue.
That's it.
Interesting, okay. But there's no,
There was no material finding.
No material finding this year, so...
No material finding. Last year, I think it was the rec committee, it was the material finding.
Yeah, and we resolved that, or resolving it.
Yes. Okay. So that was not on the agenda, by the way, I added, yeah, sorry about that, yes.
Freestyle.
New year, annual reports, committee chairs, that's, you know, we'll get into that, I think, as we get, maybe right after town meeting. So I did, letter regarding the budget committee activities that we talked about sending out as a general mailer. It is in there, so when it comes to that, we can, I think it's in there, we can take a look at it. Let's do the rest of the agenda so we can get, so we'll handle that then. So, at the garden club's last meeting, the garden club would like to install a beehive at the community garden. There is no ordinance, that says one can't do it. We have residents in town who have beehives. This would be a beehive right to the right of that little stage as you're looking at it. So from a setback, excuse me, a setback point of view, it's yards and yards and yards from any boundary. But what is the, does the board have any thoughts on any of this?
My only concern is the rec committee, because we go over there and the kids that have an allergy to bees or a fear of bees. My daughter has a very fearful fear of bees, whether they're honeybees or not. So,
so there will be signage.
So the kids won't be able to go over there anymore.
Well, the kindergartner, I mean, they're still bringing the school kids.
I guess the kindergartners go there too.
Yeah, they will still bring, because we have a board member who's from school.
Well, that's their issue, but as a rec, I can't, that they're, we have minimal staff over the age of 18. A school is much different than a rec, so I'll have to discuss it with the rec, but personally, my daughter will not be walking over there. I know there's a beehive right on the corner of, I think it's Pine and Willie, or not Locust, the other one. Anyway, but it's
okay.
Close to the school, but it's not something we visit. We don't visit their house.
Yep.
So if it's in a different location, would that make it easier, I wonder?
The activity would still be increased.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah,
there are bees now. I mean, they're bees. I mean,
they're bees now because
it's
a garden, right?
It's a garden.
Right. Right.
But there would likely be more bees.
Right.
Right? There would be more.
And we had kids that were allergic last year that got stung when they were on a field trip. So I don't want
to
increase
the
possibility.
So what happened in those situations?
They had to give them an EpiPen.
Who does that?
Is staff.
So we have staff who are trained to be able to.
Yeah.
But the kids must bring their own with them?
They carry it in their, I think they were, I
or
think
we
the
have one
camper
for our staff
was carrying it in their backpack.
Yeah.
The camper has to supply it.
Right.
Yeah, that would make sense. I hate to think we were.
But we do have, we were supposed to get an EpiPen last year.
Just to have it.
Yeah.
I will relate, I will bring that back to the garden club.
That's my only concern.
I mean,
and then the rec committee can just choose not to walk down that way. That's fine.
I'm going to wait to have a discussion with the rec committee before we make a recommendation on either yes or no.
We meet on, I think we meet this week.
I wasn't taking that as a yes or no from the board. I was just going to bring it back to the garden club and say there is this additional concern.
Yeah, that's what I'm
Are
saying.
You?
Yeah, and we'll wait, and Jody will reach out to the rec committee and see if there are concerns there too.
Yeah, we meet on the 4th, so next Monday I'll have an answer.
Okay. I'll keep that on the agenda. All right, thank you. Oak Street boundary, nothing there. Dental insurance, do you want to bring us up to date on that? Do you have stuff?
So they sent out a flyer.
Could you set the stage? Yeah, because
yes,
I don't know how much of it we've already talked about here.
Offering dental was a concern of mine, and we didn't have enough staff. Now we have enough staff to meet the 75%, which now is dropped down to 50%, apparently, according to their new flyer.
So I think it's six out of eight want it. And then the insurance company sent us three options. There are more options, he said, but these are the most popular. Looking at them, option 1S with a $2,000 maximum is probably the best, but the cheapest, which gives all the same benefits except for braces. And it's $5 less a month for a single, $10 less a month for a couple, and then almost $20 a month less for a family.
And just
so
to be clear,
this year it wouldn't come out of our budget. They would pay it 100% because we didn't budget for dental.
Right, so that's what I wanted to be clear. This was going to be a self-funded.
Yes.
That they would understand,
yes,
that the town is not supplying dental, just
we're
providing
just
them the opportunity to enjoy a benefit of the group rates.
Right. So, if the board wants, I can give Caroline that we chose option 3, which is 100% preventative, 80% on fillings, gum disease, root canals, things like that, 50% on partials, dentures, onlays, crowns, no ortho benefit, and a deductible of $25 a person or $75 a family, with a maximum out-of-pocket, maximum per person per plan year is $1,000.
So that's the one that we would
offer this year.
So. I'm fine. I don't have any stake in this. I mean, I don't have enough expertise to.
I mean, if they're.
Are you saying that this? It's better to have to say to employees, here's the plan. Decide yes or no if you want to take it, or did rather than checking in. Well, yeah, I don't. I mean, one is it's a little more. It's more administrative.
Right. Well, Caroline wanted us talk to her before the meeting and to tell us what you think this option is, and then have the gentleman come in and present to the staff.
So he would just present the one that we asked him to present. I'm fine with that.
Anything less than this, I wouldn't recommend taking. Because when you do have the numbers, it also includes 4 platings a year, which is where dentistry is going. So, yeah. And if you do have Delta Dental, then they have a new program. This is a Delta Dental pop thing. They call it the HOW program or NOW program. And all your dentist has to do is fill out a form online, and if your insurance only covers 2, your now insurance will cover 4. All your dentist has to do is fill out the form online. So, just for your FYI.
It's fine, but that's no cost to the town.
Right.
Would it be a cost to the town next year?
That'll be up to you guys.
So your
options are not paying it, and having the employee pay all of it. You pay all of it, or I believe there is a 50% option.
So by offering this plan this year, we're not necessarily obligating the next board to fund it.
Absolutely not.
That's all I'm asking.
Yeah, absolutely not.
Okay.
What we're offering is an opportunity to, again, to get the advantage of a group rate.
That's fine.
But it would be self-funded.
That's fine. Yeah, and
then go for it. All right, great. Thank you. Policies and procedure, welfare, there's no action there. All right, I think we're down to town administration.
Historical committee is meeting on Thursday night, 7 o'clock in this very room.
Very good. Anything else happening?
Meeting with Russ on Sunday.
There's a person from Brookfield, New Hampshire, who is interested in how we use the road surface management system. So I'm meeting with her this week.
Oh, yeah.
She's a planning board person. So
yeah.
Otherwise, I'm quite weak. All right, ready for your folder, Mike?
Inoki, so the first thing we have here is a survey from
ICMA, which I'm still going to throw a little on.
Survey.
International City County Management Association. It's through the Wharton School at the University of Pennsylvania. It's their real estate program, just doing a survey of the types of property we have in town. And is that Caroline Tamarmy? Is that yours?
Don't stop on.
Okay. So,
I haven't seen that.
Would you like to complete this?
Oh.
I don't mind what you may have. Oh, no. Yeah, okay. See if I can. I don't mind what you may have. I don't know. Different views. Asking you because it's planning related. Oh, good. Okay. I guess, yeah, I'm happy to fill it out.
I'm fine with that.
And it's
Jody?
Just, yeah. I can read you the question. It said, in your community, how involved are you with the following affecting residential building activities? So I guess, what? Oh man, what is this about? Survey about me or about the property? I'll take a look at it. I'll report back to the next week.
That's fine.
Next is from Andrea to the select board. I'm providing you with a copy of this abatement as the letter requests a meeting with the board of selectmen. Member of the board, please find an abatement application in duplicate for fiscal year 2017. Also included in your review is a map of that highlights the property that is primarily located in Dover, New Hampshire, and is adjacent parcel from which improvements were included in the assessment of the above mentioned parcel. During the informal hearing period, we met with a member of the Avatar Associates. To discuss this parcel had essentially served as an excess land. At this time, the representative from Avatar agreed that this site and yet and another adjacent site owned by the same entity should only be assessed as excess land and reduce the value of the land. Between the informal hearing period and the release of the final values, a portion of a building from an adjacent parcel was added to the assessment of this parcel. We immediately informed the town of this error, who referred us to Avatar, but Avatar was unresponsive. For well over a month. We made subsequent calls, requests, which went unanswered. And by the time we heard back from Avatar, the values had been finalized and no corrections were made. Is this the people in Massachusetts? I think so. That own the plaza. Part of it's in our town, part of it, yeah.
What plaza?
Tri-City.
Oh, I was going to tell you in a second.
I think in the
Hanford plaza. Yeah, Central Avenue, Rollins Street. Okay. 851 Central Ave, LLC.
Yes.
Huntington Avenue, Boston. Meeting with us, so we can respond whether or not we wish to set up a meeting with them or not.
All right, so we'll set up a time probably at one of these meetings. That would be the best.
Thing. The only other thing I have is a building permit is 2018-011, 278 Sligo Road. They are reshingling part of the roof. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. The fee is $135.
Caroline looks at yours though.
What was it, Mike? A roof?
Roof. Yep, part of a roof, not the whole roof.
Yeah.
And the fee is $135. Yeah. That's all I got. Serving now a little bit.
all right.
I get it.
Do you want to take care of that? It's hanging outside your folder?
Yes.
So
Pound Oak Street, this is the DOT, Bureau of Planning and Community Assistance. This is our big old map of all of our streets. Ironically, it highlights mostly Dover. So, Oak Street is here.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the Oak Street part that you guys were wondering about.
Mm-hmm.
So, it looks correct on the map from what we've all been talking about. But give this to George. Where our cul-de-sacs are and so forth. But they left the Dover part much more highlighted. So this is the one's work.
Well, maybe there are no streets. I mean, where's the village?
Oh, that's true.
No.
So it seems. Yeah, so what are they asking us to do? And are we asking George to do it for us? Is that, map is included for a view of current inventory. There's no need to return the map. And there's a collection form to update, to report any updates. So it's critical this information accurately reflects local governing body decisions to street changes, additions, and deletions.
So
there have been no formal...
Greenview Drive is on here, but we don't own that yet. But Scotland isn't on here.
Scotland is a class 6.
Not Scotland. Well,
what?
Thank you. The what? The Chinworth houses. What is that called?
Wentworth. At least part of it has always been there. Do they have the whole development there?
They don't have any of the development.
Yeah, we don't. It's not a.
I see.
We have not accepted the street yet.
Yeah, but we didn't accept Greenview.
Correct.
That's on here.
All right. So get it posted. We'll have George maybe work with Caroline, because Caroline is.
Water Street, Pleasant Street, Washington Street, Railroad Ave. That's it.
How about the change on the end of Sligo and. Pinchill, the T intersection. Or it was Y, and now it's T. Has that been changed on our own?
I gotta get my bearings here.
Yeah, the river. Just generally speaking.
Silver Street, Sligo. Sligo, Lane, Pinchill. Doesn't say if it's a Y or a T, it's just a dot.
Oh.
And then, what was the latest? Gagnon Hill. It's private.
It's private.
And your street is private too.
Are these only public ways that are?
They're the ways that I think they use this inventory in order to calculate the block grant. Right.
But so then they noted a driveway right here on Roberts Road, driveway A-141, which. So. I'll take a look at it and send it to George.
It's to facilitate and coordinate program and project communications with public officials. So, road inventory. I'm happy to have you take a look at this one. And forward along to George, you might also want to work with Caroline. Whatever seems to be the most... best way to get an accurate response to the state.
All right. Stormwater Coalition, we're going to look at it next week, but I think it can hold off till next week because I was looking at it. And
did you look at it?
A couple of pages in, it gives like summer reports and And then there's, right in here, there's a Rollinsburg one.
Right. Maybe I'll have Caroline. Yep. I still don't see us. Can you point it out?
The whole page is Rollinsburg. So you have Rollinsburg, you have Portsmouth, you have Durham.
Yes, so, okay, so we still have some, this was our dues. So this is an accounting of our dues, and obviously $230 of it went to one of these services here. So there is a Stormwater Coalition meeting this week, and unfortunately I can't attend. Do you mind if I take this material home to read?
Absolutely not.
All right, for the best. I'll take a look at this.
Do you still have it?
No, I will remember.
Okay.
It's paper, it's dangerous, I'm green, but I'm hoping for the best. Hoping for the best.
Okay, this is the rescheduled hearing of our former road agent.
Are you still able to go to that? March 7th.
March 7th at 9:45.
As far as I know, but I'll know for sure on Friday.
In the bridge inspection, still in here. Health Trust public notice March 8th in Ashland and in Concord. On July, medical ratings for the 2019 year in surplus returns. So if anybody's interested. Community action for Stratford County.
Is there a name of the report?
It is. I figured it was a donation, but it's their annual report. So do you mind if I take that?
No.
I'm going to take that to work and show everybody. So. This is a letter McRevocal Trust for Roofing at 407 Main Street.
Oh, it's a letter saying, hey, are you doing something?
Is yeah.
They already did it, they didn't get a building permit.
Okay.
There's a lovely sign thing.
Roofing by?
Yeah.
Yeah, they did actually. They put a sign up after they put it up the next day, so.
Okay.
This letter was in here last week with our MOA.
Either way, that's just, unless that's the radio one. I told Caroline, you didn't, I know we talked about the radio, but we didn't actually sign a radio one. But if this is the one that's already signed by us about the streets,
yep.
Then that's different. So,
file this.
File it, please, yes. On the floor.
Floor.
On the floor. It's on the floor.
Yeah, I'll write it later.
Between you and.
All right, road safety audit application.
All right, so that was taken off the website. So this is the audit that the gentleman who was at the head of safety for DOT. Mike Dukas, was that his name?
I don't remember.
That's what he suggested. It's going to require somebody to spend a little bit of time to fill this out. He thought we should check in with SRPC. The guy said, well, you know, you can start this. You've got the data. So if anyone wants to take a stab at starting this or taking a look at it, maybe it's not relevant. I don't know who we need to get data from.
Signature of DOT district engineer. Crash reports for fatal or serious injuries in the past 10 years. That's police. Who's the fire? So that's their number one main concern. Reasoning for requesting. So, what was our MOA for Dover for? Sorry.
This is Oak Street.
winter.
No, no, what do we want the one for?
The radio from Chief Colarusso. The analog radio. Unless it's in there somewhere.
No, I didn't see it. I looked through it earlier. Okay. So purchase order. Move to accept purchase order 1362 to DMV Printing for 25 zoning ordinance books.
Yeah, right.
When the other one was banned?
I don't know what happened to the other one at this point, but there's no amount.
It's a new year.
It's not a purchase order unless there's an amount. Assessing?
Yeah, on the assessing.
Okay, so it just needs to be filed.
Okay, and your letter.
Okay, so that's the one. There's just one copy for us to sign, so you can read it, Mike can read it, and then we can figure it out. Okay.
Why did you decide on that, though, since you got it there? Because is someone going to do something, or?
I can ask the chief to look at it.
Yeah.
Look at it first.
Yeah.
Okay. Because it's all stemmed from Bear. Bear and.
It's Portland Ave.
But the junction of Portland Ave.
And Bear and Roberts.
Roberts.
I think was the principal account, but. I don't know if it has to be, does it have to be that focused? I mean, I we're sort of looking at the entire Portland Ave issue, but maybe that's too broad for that road surface safety. I don't know. Well, we could.
The council will take a look at it.
I did send it to him.
Oh, okay.
I'm hearing.
Yes, did it?
Nope.
Did he have an opinion?
We didn't hear back.
Actually, I'd like to wait to hear back from him.
I didn't see an email.
I said I was sending it to him last week, so I did. That was how that happened. All right, well, I'll be happy to wait. There is the
if we send it out with the voter's guide, it would cost us less. If we send it out individually, it would cost us more. So is that something to keep in mind? It doesn't...
When were we hoping to have the...
I don't really know what the current... I'm going to ask our... Do you know when the voter's guide is ready for printing? Is that been...
They signed the purchase order last week, so it should be at the printer now, right?
No, it hasn't gone to the printer. I think Carolyn's going to bring it tomorrow.
Okay. All right, so I'm happy to...
I don't have a problem with it. I think it's fine. I'm not an attorney.
No, no, I understand. Yeah, I understand. No problem. Anything else?
That's all I got.
So we have the possibility of non-public legal, because there are a couple of right to know things, but again, we didn't hear. I don't have anything.
We did hear from Steve on one of them.
When?
Today?
I mean, last week he said he was in receipt of these and that somebody would perhaps be working on these on Monday, but I didn't...
Well, is that how it was left? I couldn't remember if that's
yes.
how it was left.
Yes,
we were supposed to respond.
Yeah, so...
Right.
So there isn't anything other than the receipt of these.
Other
than, by the way, what seems to be a really confused situation with regard to the Megan right to know and their attorney.
Did
you read the response to that?
Yeah, the attorney didn't actually send it to us.
The attorney said, well, I didn't really send that, and then went off on this riff about the current use, which had nothing to do with the...
Right.
So I just stopped reading it at some point and said...
Yeah, she's about 8 months behind.
It was crazy.
So I'll plan on replying on Monday. Okay. We
didn't hear anything, so that was just in case we heard something later on this afternoon.
Ready to hear from the public and go on.
All right, community input, public input.
Are the housing standards available?
They should be.
They're on the website.
Yeah, they're on the website.
Okay.
They're also, if you need a hard copy, just ask. They're also available in that way.
Have you considered for the transfer station? I know there was something in the auditor's report about it, about repetitive or repeat offenders who go in week after week with no sticker, who may say they have it, but they don't actually have one.
Well, my understanding is we're not letting them in.
And we call the police, right?
Yeah.
That's part of the ordinance already. So.
And is there a fine to go with it, or are they just trying to...
I don't know about the whether we're applying a fine, but there's misuse of the transfer station is accompanied by a fine.
And then on Portland app, I would be curious to see how many accidents also occur at the corner of Oak Street and
Broadway.
No, Oak and Portland, because I've been caught in traffic a couple times when there's been accidents at that intersection.
Okay.
So
thank you.
That's another trouble spot.
So noted. Anything else? Charlie?
What about political sign for voting for articles on town property?
Not on town property.
There shouldn't be any.
We issued that policy last year.
Oh, yeah. There was one at the bottom of the overpass tonight. Article 6.
By further in or right by the, which traffic
the triangle.
There must be the one further up by the cemetery.
The
like
one
when you
right
come down
the
around.
Cemetery.
All right,
yeah.
I come by the other
yeah.
one. Okay. I didn't see it. So. All right. Yeah, there shouldn't be any.
We did write something last year, I thought.
We should send it out again.
Yeah. I think it's cool. Something about insurance.
There shouldn't be. The only thing that should be there are the notices.
Maybe it's not an ordinance. It's a policy, right?
It's a state law.
Mm-hmm.
It says it's
right, but I said I thought we wrote something, but I don't think we wrote it as an ordinance.
Oh no, it was an advisory. I think it was, we're advising people remember that state law says it should be on private property.
Yeah, I don't see anything. We put something out on the website. I thought.
Yeah.
solicitations, drug-free, I don't know where it would be.
Political signs.
In development.
I know we put something on the website last year, so maybe it's somewhere in there. I don't mind looking through to see if we...
So my note says this particular thing is not signed. We can check the minutes and see when we authorize it. So I think we did authorize it. So what it says, I can read it. State primaries and national state elections will be fast upon us. That's not quite right. But in light of that, the select board would like to remind residents that per RSA 664:17, no political advertising shall be placed on or affixed to any public property, including highway rights of way. So it's state.
Right.
Nor shall they be placed on private property without the owner's consent. Town reserves the right to remove such signs on public property. And then it states the full statute, which
right.
is 664:17.
We should put that out again so people know. It's not, usually more of an issue with the state and national elections.
Right.
People typically buy signs of those. But less so, I guess, with town elections. There's still signs to put out.
All right. Oh, so. There is a request for disbursement from the trustees of the library. I just happened to see it. Remember, it was the thing from Lorraine and it was missing?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So, did everybody get this or am I the only one?
No, I saw the email. There wasn't a... All
right. So, the amount of request of disbursement is $2,000 for, collection development.
She literally was
there. Pardon? So, I will entertain a motion to authorize this.
So moved.
Second.
All right, any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I will sign this tomorrow.
Okay.
And
print it out.
Yeah, print it out. Let me make note of that.
Certainly, some of those losses.
Just a minute, let me find you two. Yes.
When do you want the voter's guide? When do you
possible.
Want people to receive that?
As soon as possible.
Yeah, there's no
as
reason really
it doesn't
to,
fall on a Wednesday
to
that they receive it.
Why is that important?
Because on Wednesdays, the flyers from the grocery store come out.
Really?
And they'll get thrown into the trash with
that's
their grocery store stuff.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So, I don't want them to overlook it. Just
okay.
like a stuff plan.
Okay. All right, so I'll talk to Caroline and we'll...
If you wanted to go out as soon as possible, when are you going to decide on that letter?
I don't know. We have to wait till we hear from our attorney, from our legal counsel, so...
I mean, I think it's fine. I don't have a problem with it, but again, like I said, I'm not...
So if he says it's fine...
Then I'm fine with it,
okay.
So I don't know what George says, but I'm fine with it, so.
All right, so we'll see. I think he's busy. he's
Literally.
Busy. Anything else? Okay. Well, consensus. I think we're ready to rock and roll.
Yay. Have a good night, everybody.